who has called us to be thy soldiers and to fight manfully on the Christ banner. Enable us constantly to contend for truth, goodness, and justice without fear or terror. And relentlessly propose evil wherever it is found, and whatever form it takes. In the name and strength of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Thank you. want to welcome all of those on our Zoom network. Good morning, and we pray this service is indeed a blessing and inspiration to you.
Today is the 21st Sunday after Pentecost. The collect reading is going to be found in your bulletin. Our service continues on page 7 of the book. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to your hearts are open, all desires beloved from you, the secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name.
Amen.
He has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases. Yet we have counted him stricken, struck down by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole. And by his bruises we are healed. All we, like sheep, have gone astray. We have all turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep that before its shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. By a perversion of justice, he was taken away. Who could have imagined this human? For he was cut off from the land of the living, stricken for the transgression of my people. They made his grave with the wicked and his tomb with the rich, although he had done no violence and there was no deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the will of the Lord to crush him with pain. When you make his life an offering for sin, he shall see his offspring and shall prolong his days. Through him, the will of the Lord shall prosper. Out of his anguish, he shall see light. He shall find satisfaction through his knowledge. The righteous one, my servant, shall make many righteous, and he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore, I will allot him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong, because he poured himself out to death. And he was numbered with the transgressors. Yet he bore the sin of many and made intercession for the transgressors. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Because you have made the Lord your refuge, and in the Most High your habitation, there shall be no happy to you, neither shall any plague come near your dwelling, for he shall give his angels charge over you, to keep you in all your ways. They shall bear you with their hands, lest you dash your foot against a stone. You shall tread upon the lion and adder. You shall trample the young lion and the serpent under your feet. Because he is bound to be in love, therefore will I deliver him. I will protect him because he knows my name. He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I will rescue him and bring him to honor. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation.
A reading from the book of Hebrews. Every high priest chosen from among mortals is put in charge of things pertaining to God on their behalf, to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. He is able to deal gently with the ignorant and the wayward, since he himself is subject to weakness. And because of this, he must offer sacrifice for his own sins, as well as those of the people. And one does not presume to take this on, but takes it only when called by God, just as Aaron was. So also Christ did not glorify himself in becoming a high priest, but was appointed by the one who said to him, "You are my son. Today I have begotten you. And he also, in another place, you are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek. In the days of his flesh, Jesus offered up prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverent submission. Although he was a son, he learned obedience through what he suffered. And having been made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. Having been designated by God a high priest according to the order of Melchizedek. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Those whom they have recognized as their rulers lord it over them,
and their great ones are tyrants over them. But it is not so among you. But whoever wishes to become great among you must be your servant. And whoever wishes to be the first among you must be slave of all. For the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
I speak to you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. Words from the Gospel read, Mark's Gospel, the 10th chapter, verses 43 through 45. So Jesus called them and said to them, "You know that among the Gentiles, those whom they recognize as their rulers lord it over them, and their great ones are tyrants over them. But it is not so among you. But whoever wishes to become great among you must be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first must be slave of all. For the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for men." I've entitled this sermon this morning, "Real Greatness, Last and Servant of All." Real greatness, last and the servant of all. Our gospel today tells us about the justing for privilege prestige in God's kingdom by two brothers, James and John, who thought that they deserved special treatment over the other 10 disciples. But when word got out that the brothers had the audacity to try to hoodwink Jesus into granting them some prestigious positions, the rest of the disciples were not pleased. The text tells us, when the 10 heard this, they began to be angry with James and John. How dare you go up to the master and try to push us aside? You can imagine with me the kind of conversation that transpired in that moment. Use your creative powers to think about it. Now, this incident is also recorded in Matthew's gospel, but it is not the brothers asking for such a favor. It is the mother. All mothers love to see us in good position to defend. So the mother went up to Jesus, put him aside and said, look, make a good place for my boys. You know how things are. Give my boys some big standing in your kingdom. However, Mark's brutal honesty about the proclivity of the brothers reminds us that they were not paragons of virtue, but very ordinary people like you and me. The gospel also gives us some insight into the thinking of James and John and the mother. They were ambitious and opportunistic. It is in this context that Jesus had to help the disciples and us see the meaning of real greatness. Real greatness is not about positions of power and prestige, but about humility and service. Not in doing as I say, but in doing as I do. That is why Jesus tells them, but it is not so among you. But whoever wishes to become great among you must be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first must be slave of all. Here then, we see in this teaching of Jesus the three components of real greatness. First, service. Secondly, leadership as encouragement. And third, sacrifice. We live in a world where real greatness is not about serving others or being nice. Our culture does not allow that. It is about how you must always be praised for every little thing you do. I say we must not be grateful for people's kindness. But if no one says anything to you about what you do, do not send an article to the New York Times telling the whole world, oh, I'm grateful, so and so is. Again, real greatness for the world is so often about being ahead of the pack and having no regard for the others. It is about one's own self-aggrandizement and the ability to rule others. COVID-19, in a sense, helped us to see real greatness when all of a sudden custodians and those at the end of the line were hailed as great, because without them, hospitals and hotels would have been inhospitable places. So, real greatness, as Jesus lays it out in our gospel, is firstly service. Our ability to invest ourselves for the welfare of others. Feeding the hungry. Providing shelter for the homeless. Simply being polite to all, irrespective of one's status. Simply put, service is exercising radical hospitality and care for all. Secondly, real greatness, as Jesus lays down in our gospel, is about leadership as encouragement and not having to be upfront, not having to be always first. The burden of having to be always first is too weighty a thing and is unsustainable. So Jesus helps us to be more whole in our leadership, in our authority, by sharing power, not as a sign of weakness, but as testimony of knowing oneself and not leading with fear. The third, real greatness, as Jesus lays it out in our gospel, is about sacrifice. Giving our time for ministry, giving of our money to support mission, giving of our talent to rejoice hearts. As St. Ignatius of Loyola says, to give and not to count the cost, to fight and not to heed the wounds, to toil not to ask for rest, to labor and not to ask for any reward, save that of knowing that you do thy will. This must be the mantra of what it means to be a volunteer, to be someone who gives for the sheer joy of giving and love. However, sad to say, sacrifice is becoming a foreign concept in our culture of instant, a Wentworth reality. It is my money and I need it now. A Wentworth reality. Jesus' model when a real grace is wrapped up in the 45th verse of this 10th chapter of Mark's gospel. Jesus says, for the Son of Man came not to be served, and to give my life a ransom for many. May this too be ours, as we be and serve in God's one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church.
Amen. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, describe your living Father, now and for all.
Please stand as we now affirm our faith by saying together the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, by the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. And his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. If the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken to the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world.
Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
That every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will, all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others. In the Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for the church and the province of the West Indies. As of New York, we pray for Michael, our presiding bishop, Alan and Mary Andre. We pray for Heather already. Let us now start to pray for all of those listening who have especially requested our prayer. We continue to pray for the people of Haiti and the people of Afghanistan. We pray for the souls of the soul of Valentine and Yahweh. May his soul and all the souls of the faithful departed rest in peace. We pray for all the nations that are currently suffering. from the coronavirus pandemic. We pray for all the frontline and essential workers in our parish, of Staten Island and the world. We pray for those who are suffering from any physical, mental, and or economic effects of the coronavirus pandemic. We pray for those who are suffering from the impact of systemic racism, for those who are committed and working hard towards change, towards unity, and equality for all of God's people. We pray for Kirsten as she continues to become a priest. We give thanks to God for the following individuals for celebrating the birthday: Carol Branson, Heather Delvalle, Nathaniel Seeley, Danielle Scott, John Green, and Deborah Lindsay.
Let us pray. O God, our times are in your hand. Look with favor, we pray, on your servants as they begin another year. Grant that they may grow in wisdom and grace and strengthen their trust in your goodness all the days of their life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. O Lord, our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people in the multitude of your mercies. Look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Page 360. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Let us say together, most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will
and walk in your ways, the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you.
Give you all the sins to our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let's now share the peace with your neighbor.
And to my Zoom audience, peace be with you.
Let us pray as we hear now for the liturgy of Christ. Walk in love as Christ loved us. He gave himself up for us and offered his sacrifice for my God.
Thank you. Eucharistic prayer, A on page 361. And it begins on page 16 in the bulletin. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. For you are the source of light and life. You made us in your image and called us to new life in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices of angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we have fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, O Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many
for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension. We offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to sing. Hallelujah. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah.
Jesus, we give you. gift of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith for thanks.
Let us pray. Most communion prayer. Let us say it together. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Now after him who was able to do more than we could ever ask or imagine, the only wise God, we honor, glory, dominion, and power.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you, and upon all those who love and care for you here and in paradise, this day and for all time. If you may be seated for the announcements.
Good morning, everyone. There are a lot of announcements in the bulletin. There's 2 or 3 pages worth. So I suggest that everybody keep their copies so you don't have to listen to me read through everyone. Pick and choose which one you want to take part in helping to provide the services that Father has talked about. And a lot of these events is about serving our community, our church community, our neighboring community, and even some of the other Christian family churches. A few special things, the 4 day-by-day booklet is available. There are a few pamphlets that are here. If you'd like for us to slow mail them, please call the office, leave your address, and they will send it to you. October 31st is New Sunday Christ Church. And it's also Halloween, which is for by and large for you. And then we will be hosting a Halloween community coffee hour. If you'd like to come and help decorate, bring any candy or mini goodies, get money for this event, please call Heather Nicolli, birthday girl, or Nicole Haylock, or Carol Brandon, another birthday girl. We have the correct date again now for the virtual in-person tea party for November 14th. Once again, please use all of the other announcements.
We have some very special announcements this morning. I'm going to begin first with our music director, organist, communication, techie, guru, all that, and then speak to us. But over the next few weeks, you're going to see some changes in how we organize the technology we have for public broadcasting and all that stuff. And I'm going to allow him to speak to that so that you are aware as to what we will be doing. The umbrellas, this may be offensive to some, will be going shortly, but we're going to have another visual that you will see, and I want to allow him to speak to that. Anthony, tell us what we're going to have, what we're going to see.
No, I think I'll just come out here because I'm loud enough. Father God actually talked at all. But since he actually did, I guess I will. Far be it for me to turn that up to the state. Good news, I guess, good news is that the light streaks, having become ubiquitous umbrellas, will be going away. Well, I hope it's not too bad news. We are going to be continuing live streaming, but with a different platform. It won't be Zoom anymore, which is a good platform for discussion and practice. but not such a good platform for live music and that kind of thing. So we're moving to a different live platform, Facebook Live and YouTube Live, and we're installing some new equipment, which won't have I'll point out where it is. It will be visible, but not, I hope, really glaring. So I just want to talk about that. I'm trying to keep everything in kind of appropriate for this beautiful little space to help this environment of all wires. Just so you know what it's about. And if you have any questions, please go catch me or me or coffee hour or whatever. And thank you for having me.
Thank you, Reverend Lee, for being on technical on hand by making things happen in that reverend and seek to
help our online audience. I know there's one there who would not want us to go offline because
she is here every week and says, Father, and bless every week. So please do not go offline. So whether it's Zoom or Facebook, or
YouTube, we will let you know.
We had a wonderful presentation yesterday at the Cathedral of St. John Divine. As you are aware, we are working with our Liberian community on a mission to Liberia. Hopefully we will begin that more fully or get ready going on this in 2022. When the pandemic and the subside. One thing you want to do is to have a trip to Liberia so that we can more fully assess what's needed. We wrote a grant to the Sustainable Development Goal grant, and we were awarded that grant for $10,000 to help. We were represented at the recognition award yesterday by Richard Zaza, Bill Sherman, and Susan Paul. I could not be there because we were having ministry day at the church. And they represented the church well. And this is the certificate, which I certainly will probably hang somewhere in the church that others may see. So we're not talking just about mission within these four walls, this community. We're reaching beyond ourselves. And this project has been going on for a while. We shouldn't be really afraid of COVID, but the spoke everybody's been, and we are a little bit behind. So we will say more about that as time comes on. We're still working, get some details for travel, etc. But we will let you know what's happening. If you want to go there, help them to rebuild the educational system at two of the schools. Go along worldwide organization, Bristol High School in Liberia. We're working together with them in order to support St. John's and what's the other school? St. Augustine School in Liberia. They are in need of our support. We have several things here already that we've stored, but we will be working with them. So that's our mission abroad, and this is the grant that we received from the Baptist to the SDG website. Good news. It is stewardship time. And so I'm going to invite our stewards to cheers. Dr. Lester Blair and Andrew Morris Roth. We come forward and tell you a little bit about the program that we have established for this year before we get going to coffee on this morning. They led us through 2020 and 2021. Why not 2022?
Well, good morning, Christ Church. Yes, it is stewardship time. Today is the first day of our stewardship campaign. And we're going to be asking you, over the course of the next several weeks, for several things. Our theme this year is Every Perfect Gift. I would ask you all, look into your bulletins, pages 24 and 25. There's a message from Father Babb. And I would ask you, for some time during this week, when you're not stressed by a lot of other things and you have a few moments, just carefully read through those two pages and think about your commitment to the church. 3 weeks from today, we will be distributing the pledge card, and on December 5th, we'll have the ingathering of the card. Thank you.
He did say it's going to be short and soon. Thank you, Doctor. Thank you, sir. One other answer. This is crucial. If any of you have received an email from the church, from my email, asking for a gift card from Amazon, please ignore it. It's not from me. My email account has been hacked. And so there's a flood. I've received at least no less than 60 calls already from friends, people in the diocese, friends from North Carolina, all around the place, because they're receiving these emails and saying, this does not sound like so you see, we're working on it. I've already changed the password to the email account, but I was told by my IT group that they can go in and also run malware and all that stuff. And so I'm working on that this afternoon. Plus, I need to call Horizon, since it is the horizonnet.net, to see what they can do to have it work. So I have been hacked, but all will be done. Thank you so much. The final hand, crown him with many things. Thank you.